when you're doing this, I saw a lot of you guys doing this, but some of you did struggle. When I'm first getting her into the position, I'm here, and I'm just using this hand to palpate the TL junction, then I switch. And then to facilitate a little bit more of a flexion, it's in the notes, I didn't go over it because it's, you'll learn more when you're doing mobilization. I can just purely rotate her, or I pull her arm down this way, so I'm actually getting a little bit of flexion from above just to bias her system into flexion. So that's what's in your notes, so I wanted to explain it. And then remember, you're going to, you feel resistance, and then I'm gonna go into that resistance a little bit to get more of a stretch, which she may or may not feel if she already is at just about 4 inches. You just spasmed a little bit there. Yeah. When your hand is here, you are monitoring for spasms, for feeling the tissue stretched there. As you get better with your hands, when you're moving people, you'll be able to get a sense of this side is gliding nicely, this side's a little restricted, and you might see and feel one side moving more than the other side. So that hand back here is doing a lot. It's gathering a lot of information. You're monitoring to see if the stretch or your mobilization when you learn them is going above where you want it to go, but you're monitoring the soft tissue. If things start to spasm, probably gonna back off because something else is going on there, okay? So if I wanna do extension, so back in here, it's the same thing in reverse. Okay, so now I'm moving her into lumbar extension. I'm stretching what structures?
Flexors.
Good. So I'm still here. She's still 90-90. I'm facing the patient. Can you come a little bit closer? Okay, this is where I'm really going to put her knees in my hip because I need to be able to shift. And if I want to move her, Sandra's little enough where I could actually lift her up. But for someone who's bigger, I can't lift and move their legs without killing my back. So I'm really going to have her here and really moving my body to get her to extend here. I can also just push through her hips and get a lumbar extension moment here. It depends on if your patient can actually feel a stretch that way. But I'm still going to lock her. So I'm still getting her into a 90-90 position to start, switching hands, palpating TL junction, which I don't care how you guys do it. I always try and find the 12th rib and follow it back because that's just easier for me. I can pull her into rotation or, again, to bias a little bit more of extension, I can pull her up this way to just bias a little bit into extension. And that's a little bit more important when you're doing mobilizations, but it applies here. So now I switch my hand again. I'm monitoring. I'm looking for tissue glide. I'm looking for muscle spasms. I'm looking to gather whatever information my hand will give me. I tend to do wide. My pinky is actually a little bit above her TL. My ring finger is kind of on her TL, and then these hands are just monitoring tissue and muscle. And then I can just move her. Stop that. That's why Sandra doesn't want to relax. I swear I can do this on my own. You don't need to help. There we go. So I go into a little bit of resistance, and then I can give her a little bit of overpressure. I am also monitoring for hinges. I don't want to stretch somebody if they have a lumbar hinge and a little bit of pain there. I don't want to stretch them into that. They may not be coming to you for that. Don't make them come to you for that. Don't give them an extra issue. What if I wanted to do an agonist contract, PNF technique? What am I doing?
Push, 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 push.
Where? What is my body doing? Am I going forward or back?
Back.
So I'm going back and I'm gonna say push back. And then if I say relax, do I do this?
No.
Right, what do? Forward? I go further into extension. What if I wanted to do a contract, relax, agonist contract? Remember that one?
You do alternating.
I do alternating.
One way and then switch your hand position and have them go the other way.
Exactly. So I would say, don't let me move you forward. What am I doing? Agonist contract or contract relax?
Agonist.
Good. Relax. Move her further back. Now don't let me move you. And now I'm pulling her forward. Don't let me move. So I switch where my tension is. I make her tense her abdominals. I make her tense her extensors. And I go into it. Okay? I think that's it for extension. Go practice that.